it got to a point that it was getting old. Basically, it was just like to a point that I'm keep doing wrong and I'm gonna keep getting caught. So at some point of time, it's gotta stop. Denard Dallas. Well, I started out when I was like 21, you know, going on 22. I caught a case when I was younger and kind of messed my life up. I ain't have to do what I had to do. I ain't have to be that way, and I ain't have to be in the streets. But you know, I chose that life and I end up serving 15 years behind it. You know, but by serving 15 years, I had to sit off in a cell by myself every day. And you know, I was in trouble. I stayed in the hole. I stayed in fights. Stayed getting caught with cell phones. You know, but I had to look at my life now when I start growing and developing more. I had to understand life was just so short by when I lost my grandma in prison. So I couldn't even read or write. I couldn't even read or write, you know, because I was just so caught up in the wrong life. You choose your own destinies in life if you want to do good or you want to do bad. I started sitting down, started reading a lot, started reading my Bible, started understanding that how serious this is, because I'm about to make better decisions when I get out. By me losing my dad, it made me more stronger. So I had to start finding my way with God, finding myself with God. And I said, you know what? I'm tired of being where I'm at. I want to do something different in life. So I worked at Applebee's. Well, I worked there, no, I got two jobs. I started working for DeKalb County. I've been there almost 6 years. I've been out of prison five and a half. Just got off probation. And when I tell you, it's so easy. You gotta have your plans already. When you're locked up, you're incarcerated, you're gonna miss some peoples. But you gotta already have plans what you're gonna do when you get out. And how you can apply yourself, how you can understand that life is so short. We don't wanna keep doing wrong and keep being back in the same situation. See, a lot of us go back because guess what? We ain't had plans already. We already had our mind made up what we was gonna do. So when you look what's in front of you, you can push forward. And you can put your heart to anything that you desire to do in life. So if I can do it, can read or write, got a nice car, I ain't got no kids, got a beautiful life, got a nice place. And I still have my lacking in reading, but I'm almost about to get my GED. And I'm so proud of myself, because guess what? If I came out and did 15 years scarred up, had to go to the hole, been in a service situation, it's not hard to stay out. It's what you choose in life. If I could do it, they could do it too. It's easy. Officer Harris, that was my probation officer. He was awesome. And when he seen that my steps, how I was moving in life, hey, you know, people will give you a chance. But like I say, they'll give you enough rope to hang yourself to. Officer Harrison gave me a chance. So he gave me, like, none report. You know, at first I was getting a piss test, but he see that I was on what I need to be on. And he seen I was working. And he was like, you know what? This dude really serious about life. So you know what? I'm gonna give this man a chance. And you know, being on probation, it's not a bad thing. All they ever ask for you to do is do the right thing and report. Right now, I ain't gonna lie to you, I take anger management. And you know what? I put myself in that. Sometimes if you know, I ain't even on a probation division, but sometimes you know what? You gotta put yourself in something. Just join something, as in something positive that you could be around the right group. A lot. See, I love going every Tuesday. I take anger management because you know what? Anger management is a place, or if you want to find peace in your heart, find peace in you, find peace in yourself, and be around the right people that had your same problem. You know, sometimes you got to sign yourself up. That's just like, if you have a drinking problem, or any type of drug addiction problem, you can sign yourself or put yourself in a class. And guess what? Them classes will help. They work. But you know, sometimes we got to stop with the pride thing and just, we got to do what we need to do as right, you know, like moving forward in life, you know. I just thank God, you know, just for the opportunities for me being here to try to help other people get their life right. My plans is now that when I do get my CDLs, I want to be on the road. I want to drive them big trucks. Advice I have, to be honest with you, stay prayed up. Put God first before anything. Stay focused. Because you know what? When you start doing good, that's when the devil gonna come at your way. And especially when you come to a point you about to get out, that's when the devil really gonna come at you. That's when the temptations, everything and the evil gonna come at you. So, all I'm saying is look at the person in the mirror, look at you and face what you gotta do. You gotta focus on us right now. Focus on the future. And that will keep us out of a lot of trouble from being in the same situation, being here, going back. It ain't working. Sometimes you got to annoy situations. Sometimes you got to be the bigger man and say, you know what? I'm about to let you out of this. I'm going to walk away. And then, you know what? I'm going to keep pushing and I'm going to do the same thing. Some people just got to let go in your life. But right now, we got to try to live right. Not try, but we got to live right. Like, my plans is just to try to, not try, I hate saying try, to help people, encourage people. That's what I want. I want to work. I only got to get paid for my work. I can go to a prison right now. And if I can talk to people, I can motivate folks to get where they want to go, be where they want to be, I'm going to do it. Like I said, I had to sign myself up for anger management just to be around a positive group. People like me want to change their life, want to get somewhere. You know, these are my goals. I just want to be a motivational speaker and just start speaking to people, helping people. If you want to be successful, if you want to have nice things, man, if you want to have everything, man, you can have it. You got to put your heart to it. That's my favorite word. Whatever you want in life, put your heart to it. You got to put that to it.